What's up, everybody? Welcome to a new English bit. I'm Katia. In today's lesson, we're going to focus on the proficiency exam. I've prepared a new quiz based on my mistakes when I was doing lots of sample tests. This is the third edition so far on my channel. I hope you like it and find it useful. Are you ready to accept this advanced challenge? If so, let's kick off. Before we start, I'd like to correct one pronunciation mistake I made in the previous video. It has to do with elaborate. If it's an adjective, the pronunciation is elaborate. But if it's a verb, it's to elaborate, right? To elaborate. So it's quite tricky. Remember, adjective, elaborate, but the verb would be to elaborate. So with that being said, let's get down to business. Our quiz will have two parts. In the first part, I'm gonna give you 10 sentences with two options, A and B. You're gonna choose the correct answer and, very important, write it down. And in the second part of the lesson, we're going to check your answers. The first sentence, she wants to be a, option A, botanic, or option B, botanist. A, botanic, or B, botanist. So choose the correct answer, A or B, and super important, write it down. Number two, I have such, A, an interesting work, or option B, I have such interesting work. So the same, choose A or B, and remember to write down your answer. Number three, it's option A, quite a good idea, or option B, it's a quite good idea. Make your choice and write it down. Number four, option A, for all I know, she's not coming back to the company. And option B, for everything I know, she's not coming back to the company. Pick A or B and write it down. Let's move on to our fifth sentence. It seems self-evident, option A to me, option B for me, that you need to apologize if you put your foot in your mouth. So the same, choose the correct preposition, to or for. Number six, she's been, option A, alike, and option B, likened to Taylor Swift. Choose A or B, and remember to write it down. Number seven, I like listening to inspiring podcasts that call, option A, in action, or option B, for action. Choose the correct preposition in this sentence. Number eight, we need to lay these cliches to, option A, sleep, or option B, rest. So choose the correct verb, sleep or rest. Tomorrow to go, number nine, I don't usually get sucked, A, into the Christmas mood, or option B, by the Christmas mood. Choose the correct preposition, into or by, and write it down. And last but not least, number 10, option A, I've got into the habit of doing yoga, and option B, I've got the habit of doing yoga without a preposition. So choose A or B and write it down. And guys, before we continue and find out your score, just a super quick reminder, please make sure you're subscribed to English Bits and your notifications are turned on. There is a weekly lesson waiting for you. Thank you. So guys, now we're going to check your answers and find out your score. So the first sentence, the correct option is B. She wants to be a botanist. So botanist is a job and it's a person who studies plants. But we can use botanic with garden, a botanic garden. So if you have B, you can tick and you get 1 point. Number two, the correct option is B. I have such interesting work. In this case, it's not correct to use an. We can't use an indefinite article with work because it's an uncountable noun. But it would be correct to say, I have such an interesting job. But with work, remember, you can't use an indefinite article. Number three, the correct option is A. It's quite a good idea. So the correct position is first we've got quite, followed by A or N, then an adjective, and finally a noun. It's quite a good idea. Number four, the correct answer is A. For all I know, she is not coming back to the company. Here we've got a linker for all I know, which means that you don't know something for sure and you aren't certain about something. Was it correct? Number five, the correct option is A. It seems self-evident to me that you need to apologize if you put your foot in your mouth. So the preposition we have to use after it seems is to. It seems to me. Number six, the correct option is B. She's been likened to Taylor Swift. The verb to liken someone or something to someone or something means to say that someone is similar to someone else. Another example, I liken this place to my hometown, which means that this place is similar to my hometown. Number seven, the correct option is B. I like listening to inspiring podcasts that call for action. So after a call, we can use the preposition for, a call for something, but it's also possible to say to. So a call for something or a call to something. Was it correct? If so, add 1 point. Let's continue. Number eight, the correct option is B. We need to lay these clichés to rest. So we lay, and we can also say we put, something to rest, which means to put an end to something. Was it correct? Number nine, the correct answer is A. I don't usually get sucked into the Christmas mood. So the verb to get sucked into something means to become involved in a situation. Was it right? And last but not least, number 10, the correct option is A. I've got into the habit of doing yoga. The verb to get into the habit of doing something means to build a habit. And if it's the opposite, to finish a habit, it would be to get out of the habit of doing something. For example, I've got out of the habit of running. And guys, I've got a bonus question. Can you call to A, head, B, mind, who directed this movie? It means remember, like, can you remember? So choose the correct answer, A or B. Leave it in the comments below and I'll give you the correct option, the correct answer in our next English bit. So guys, how did it go? Did anyone get everything correct? If so, congrats. Please leave your score in the comments below. And guys, if you're studying for the proficiency exam, I highly recommend doing exercises from the book Common Mistakes at Proficiency and How to Avoid Them. It's really good, and you can find the link to the book in the description box. And guys, if you want to do more quizzes on proficiency, check out the previous editions right here. And of course, if you enjoyed this quiz and found it useful, please don't forget to give it a huge thumbs up, to subscribe to my channel, and catch me on Instagram. With that being said, thanks for watching and see you next week. Ciao for now!